Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and a very warm welcome to all audience. Welcome into the house of Sayyidah Khadijah, as the title from this is. So my name is Hamid Izzuddin, and I will be your host or moderator today. I'm sorry if my presence here, I feel a bit nervous because of these two great friends of that I respected. Alhamdulillah, we are friends, and may we continue to be friends, and inshallah, the house of Sayyidah Khadijah be blessed, inshallah. So it's gonna be a chill out session with some buhur
and coffee
fragrance and nice settings. And I would like to thank the venue, which is Muka, Muka Bar especially. This is an event space, baru lagi, so it's a level 1 in atas Muka, above Muka. Yeah, inshallah will be airing online here lah, inshallah. So to get the ball rolling, first I would like to introduce my partners here. I don't want to call it panelists, so my friends,
your brother and your sister,
my brothers and my sisters. So on my right is Hana Ismail, and on my left is Mada Tahir. So Hana Ismail, I just got kita baru kenal, so I know her as a personality. She's great in broadcasting, dah lama dengan broadcasting and community work, as well as Mada, a very vast experience in community work and social work as well. So we would like to hear from them, because they are the movers and shakers of House of Sayyidah Khadijah, especially the youth part, especially on giving. As you know, sekarang ni it's the pandemic, as COVID merisaukan lah. Tapi dalam kerisauan tu, we must reflect on ourselves, apa niat sebenarnya kita dalam kesusahan, apa niat sebenarnya kita. For the House of Sayyidah Khadijah, as I know, and I'm new, is to spread goodness, to spread awareness to the people from all walks of life, tak kisah gender, tak kisah umur, age.
So religion for that matter.
Correct. So alhamdulillah, we would like to hear, to start ball rolling, probably kita nak cakap dengan Miss Hana Ismail.
Oh, ladies first,
Hana Ismail.
MasyaAllah. Terima kasih banyak-banyak kepada host Eden Al-Junaid and my brother Mahda bin Tahir. And terima kasih juga kepada Mukhabar and House of Sayyidah Khadijah for giving us this opportunity untuk buat khidmah sebenarnya. Sebenarnya, involvement I dalam House of Sayyidah Khadijah ni, I think macam samalah macam Idin, macam Mahdar and the rest of us ni, is fairly new. Sebab apa? House of Sayyidah Khadijah ni, kita pun mulakan pun agak awal juga. Kita mula pada hujung tahun lepas. Tak salah saya, hujung tahun lepas. Dan House of Sayyidah Khadijah ni, kita mula sebagai sebenarnya perkumpulan ahli-ahli yang hanya nak menghadiri majlis-majlis ilmu. Majlis ilmu, majlis zikir di rumah Habib Hussein Al-Junaid. Jadi pada awalnya ia begitulah. Jadi bila dah ada ahli-ahli ini berkumpul, semasa musim pandemik pula tu kan, dan saya fikir bila musim pandemik ni ramai sangat Masya Allah yang memang memerlukan bukan sahaja sokongan bantuan ekonomi, tapi bantuan dari aspek kerohanian juga. Sebab saya rasa lagilah PKP 2.0 ni, memang orang lagi resah, lagi gelisah, lagi tak tentu arah tau sebenarnya. So jadi bila kita berkumpul tu, saya rasa perlu walaupun kita ni dah sama, kita dah semakin saling support, ya, we are a support system of each other, kan, tapi komuniti dekat luar sana, siapa yang nak support mereka? Siapa yang nak berikan suntikan rohani? Siapa nak berikan suntikan ekonomi kepada mereka tu? Jadi atas dasar itulah sebenarnya saya rasa Habib Hussein initiate House of Sayyidah Khadijah untuk kita sama-sama bergabung, memberi sumbangan pula, membantu pula komuniti dekat luar sana. Sebab lagilah dalam ahli House of Sayyidah Khadijah sendiri, kalau kita nampak kan, ada macam-macam peringkat umur. Dari yang peringkat umur apa ni, Joe Biden pun ada, sampailah ke peringkat umur kita-kita ni, Masya Allah. Dan mereka ini datang dengan pelbagai kemahiran dalam baik dari aspek swasta pun mahupun kerajaan dan pelbagai industri. Saya sendiri daripada industri broadcasting hiburan, Idin daripada background business, kan, Mahdar dari background service work dan social, kan. Jadi kita semua ni semua berkumpul dengan kemahiran bermacam-macam yang boleh kita sumbang balik kepada komuniti kita. Dan legacy apa yang kita nak tinggalkan, bukannya kita, nama kita sebenarnya kita nak tinggalkan, legacy macam mana kita tinggalkan kepada generasi kita yang akan datang ini. Jadi saya rasa atas concern itulah kita semua bergabung dan menubuhkan House of Sayyidah Khadijah. Yeah, that's pretty much why we are here.
Thank you for the explanation. Banyak banyak benda yang actually House of Sayyidah Khadijah is nak try to play, kan, insyaAllah, because it's for all walks of life, actually, kepada tua, kepada muda, mana-mana lah golongan, kan, it's always welcome, wish you warm welcome, do join us, or siapa yang belum like lagi kita punya, please like our Facebook page, Host Khadijah, HOSKHADIJAH, and also our Instagram. And bolehlah share, for goodness, please share this live. Semoga membawa kebaikan lah. So,
amin, for insyaAllah.
Me, actually, during the course of this session, you may, kalau ada siapa-siapa nak tanyakan soalan, boleh silakan. You may post your questions and we will pick up the questions. And insyaAllah, at the end of the session, insyaAllah, we will do a Q&A session. Yes, thank you. And for Mahda, actually, kita nak cakap pasal your what is your capacity or role that you play socially or in helping. As I know, Mahda is being very supportive. Even so, dengan COVID ni, jalan terus membantu dengan membawa anak sekali.
Mustafa is our youngest khidmah, ahli khidmah.
Anak Mustafa.
Mustafa, Masya Allah. Berapa umur Mustafa? 5 years old, Masya Allah.
Alhamdulillah. So, Mustafa and Hamzah, if you're watching, your dad is cool. So, yeah, just a little bit of the role that you're playing and what.
But alhamdulillah, I've been put in this position, so I try my best. Actually, the founder Habib Hussein, I started off with just an ad hoc help lah to distribute food packs. But slowly but surely, Habib Hussein kind of like dragged me in. Not dragged me in. I wouldn't say dragged me in lah. Bring me into the House of Khadijah. I actually focus more than on the charity and the welfare side, because Khadijah Jidia would have two wings. We focus on education and then social welfare. So inshallah, Hana will be the one that handles all the education punya programs, while I'll focus more on the social welfare, because that's what I've been doing all these years. So at the moment, I mean, we during the pandemic, the Hana said it started off during the pandemic, where we send food packs out to those who need, you know, from single mothers to the PPR, even some of the migrants, and so that are the kind of like programs in terms of charity welfare that we have done because during this pandemic. But our aspiration, inshallah, is again, you know, like the capacity that we have to work within that lah. So within our new setup, we have still, you know, consider very infant lagi lah, that our organization, but inshallah we'll build it up. That we will look for a small number of our beneficiaries, and we will focus long term with them. So rather than, you know, like, yeah, it's, you know, we also have programs where we do crisis respond. Macam this pandemic is considered crisis response, you know, like it's especially the second one. It hits, I mean, I just saw a news clipping today that the economy or the loss of business about 90%, you know, are affected by the second one. So it is what it is. You know, nobody wants this, but you know, it's such, you know, sometimes, you know, God give us more, sometimes he holds back. So this is kind of like the time that he holds back. But macam, besides the material support, like Hannah cakap lah, sometimes spiritual support pun important. I'm not denying lah, it affected me as well. You know, I'm kind of person who does social work. I'm out all the time meeting people and not being able to meet, to move, like, and you know, it's very difficult. So spiritually or mentally, it does affect everybody. You know, sometimes we just oblivious to it, and sometimes we need people to point it out to us that, you know, bro, nampak macam you affected ni, bro, kan? Stress macam, kan? So, but that's what we try to do in terms of social welfare lah, social welfare, and that will also overlap dengan education, because one of the education, nanti I think Hannah will explain, is our internal capacity education, because helping people is not easy, because you're dealing with people, kan? Kalau you deal with machine, senang, kan? You press enter, it goes down. So people, you know, and yeah, and when you do such social work, is you're dealing with your partners, you're dealing with your funders, and then you're dealing with beneficiaries as well. And also, it is a set of skill. It is a set of skill, the human skill that you need. So that's why I think kita ada kita punya internal capacity as well that we need to build. So we'll talk more later lah about all those things.
Saya sendiri lah, I would like to share my experience as perniagaan lah, jual nasi biryani ke singkat dia lah. So we go out every day. So dalam kita keluar hari-hari tu, kita kena ingat that our loved ones at home. So bila kita bawa balik tu, make sure that everything is you jaga diri lah. Begitu juga, I'm advising myself as well as you guys, kalau ada orang tua-tua kat rumah, kalau ada anak, please do take care, because as it is now, Selangor is quite in the red zone. So please ambil cakna sikit, ambil perhatian sikit. So itu sajalah nak bagi tahu. So back to Hannah. So Hannah, program apa yang ataupun aktiviti apa yang House of Saidiyah Khadijah dah buat atau ongoing, and probably in the future plans of maybe you'd like to touch on it as well.
InsyaAllah. Okay. Terima kasih, Aidin. Tadi Aidin katakan, dalam apa ni, kemelut pandemik ni kan, bila kita keluar mencari rezeki untuk anak-anak kita dekat rumah, untuk isteri kita dan keluarga kita dekat rumah, kita kena sentiasa mengambil tahu kan akan risiko yang akan kita bawa, dan bila kita kena jagalah segala SOP. Dan saya rasa dari aspek House Saidiyah Khadijah pun juga, dari aspek education, kita pun nak memberitahu kepada mereka kat luar sana bahawa bila kita keluar mencari rezeki, cari rezeki yang halal. Jadi bila kita bawa kepada keluarga kita, itu pun barakah. Because I selalu ingat apa yang mak saya always remind my father tau. You bila you keluar, you cari kerja ni, kalau you ada terambil-ambil apa benda yang tak elok ke, you jangan bagi anak makan. Macam tu tau. To that extent, she would actually always remind my father. Walaupun Masya Allah, my father orangnya memang Masya Allah lah kan. Alhamdulillah. Tapi it's always a reminder yang dia akan bagi. Jadi apa sahaja yang kita keluar, kita kena sentiasa have this in mind bahawa kita cari rezeki, kita jaga, kena jaga SOP dari segi aspek fizikal dan dari aspek rohani juga yang kita nak bagi pada anak-anak kita ni makan kan. Dan berbalik kepada aktiviti Khadijah tu, House of Saidiyah Khadijah, bila saya kata penekanan kepada aspek pendidikan, itu adalah aspek pendidikan dari dua aspek sebenarnya. Dari aspek tradisional, di mana kita ada majlis-majlis ilmu secara tradisional yang kita ada, kita bawakan para figura-figura agama, figura agamawan, figura pakar-pakar motivasi dan inspirers yang akan memberi sesi-sesi itu baik secara online maupun secara fizikal. So what we're doing so far, what we have done so far is that yang secara concern yang House of Saidiyah Khadijah lakukan adalah antaranya Hadrabah Saudan kita ada buat. Ya. Ini satu contoh majlis zikir yang kita adakan setiap hari Selasa. Alhamdulillah. Selain daripada itu, kita juga ada juga contoh macam majlis maulid bulanan yang kita cuba adakan. Juga kita hadirkan para asatizah, para figura agamawan, motivasi dan juga inspirers dalam tersebut. Dan beberapa peringatan lah. Peringatan ni macam bentuk tazkirah lah. Kalau orang yang biasa dengan term-term agama ni, tazkirah ke tausiah tu, itu antara bentuk peringatan selain daripada yang kita selipkan dalam Madras Maulid. Selain daripada itu juga, apa yang kita lakukan sekarang ini adalah kita juga memberi peluang kepada ahli-ahli kita dan juga orang-orang luar sana untuk terlibat dalam majlis khatam Quran yang kita adakan setiap minggu, Masya Allah, di mana kita akan mengagihkanlah juz-juz dalam Al-Quran tu untuk kita sedekahkan kepada ibu bapa kita sama ada yang masih hidup maupun telah meninggal dunia ataupun figura-figura yang kita rasakan Masya Allah kita perlu menghargai mereka dengan menyedekahkan Al-Fatihah dan juga ayat-ayat Al-Quran kepada mereka juga. Tapi memang ada hadis sahih yang mengatakan kan kalau kita dapat nak bantu ibu bapa kita semasa mereka masih hidup, ada cara juga yang kita boleh bantu bila mereka sudah tiada. Menyedekahkan mereka dengan ayat Al-Quran, dengan kebajikan yang kita niatkan atas nama mereka. Okay. Itu baru aspek pendidikan dari aspek tradisional. Sebab bila saya cakap kita pun ada juga approach untuk kita berikan, tawarkan kepada orang muda dekat luar sana, yang mana benda ni pun orang muda boleh turut sertai juga. Dan kita juga ada kata orang perkumpulan yang saya rancang untuk kita buat bersama-sama dengan orang muda dekat luar sana kan, for the youth out there. Antaranya adalah majlis ilmu secara online yang mungkin topik-topik berkaitan dengan pengurusan stres, kan, pengurusan mental health, pengurusan diri, lebih-lebih lagi di waktu pandemik dan sebagainya. Dan macam mana kita boleh assist mereka supaya mereka ni lebih berani untuk menghadapi dunia luar. Sebab saya rasa realiti sekarang ni lebih ganas, lebih lebih sukar untuk mereka berbanding dengan kita masa zaman awal-awal tahun 2000, kita nak kenal dunia. Saya rasa lebih mudah sebab masa tak ada internet, I suppose, kan? Tak ada social media. So the pressure is more. Dan apa yang mereka rasakan benda tu baik, tapi bila mereka lihat contoh tak ada alternatif yang boleh membantu mereka. Kalau I buat macam ni tak ada orang akan kenal I. Masya Allah, sebenarnya kalau kita tukar sedikit mentaliti dan mindset mereka itu, bahawa kalau mereka lebih beri penekanan kepada unsur rohani, insyaAllah benda itu akan diterjemahkan dalam bentuk pekerjaan mereka, dalam bentuk kehidupan mereka. They are much calmer and more relaxed to brace the aggressive world out there, insyaAllah.
All of you viewers can join in and like our Facebook page and to find out the latest and ongoings of House of Sayyidah Khadijah. And yes, Mr. Mada Tahir. Mr. Mada Tahir.
Brother Mada.
Bro. Bro, sekarang ni kita nak tahu apa ni the aspect of House of Sayyidah Khadijah ni. Dia it's sebuah NGO yang self-sustaining. That would be our ni self-sustaining. How do you self-sustain in this in this pandemic crisis? How do you like get people to help out on that initiative, whether financially or whether in strength or whatever? Maybe you can touch upon that as well.
Okay, with every NGO, social organization, sustainability, it's always a challenge. And it's a big part of the thing because you need to be able to move not just your activities but the people behind those things also need to move. So you need to sustain your team, you need to sustain your project. There's a lot of model. I mean, like I said, we are new, we are exploring all possible model of sustainability. The social entrepreneurship model, and within that one are the different model of social entrepreneurship, the organization itself engage themselves in entrepreneurship, or there are entrepreneurs who are partnering or dedicating their entrepreneurship for their organization. That's one. There's also a hardcore social work which I kind of like subscribe myself, whereby social organizations are agents for change or development within the social setup. And then we have the corporate side and the government side. And also we being an agent, should get the support as well from the corporate. You have CSR money, you have grants, you have government grants. So that's another model. the notion ialah orang kata when self-sustainable, not necessarily you self-sustainable yourself. And at the end of the day, Allah is the one who sustain. So Allah sometimes sends you means differently, sometimes through business, sometimes through well wishes. You know, if you look, there's a lot of model where there's a lot of philanthropy going on. You know, even this model is, you know, like it's practiced all around the world by big organization. You know, you have like Bill Gates Foundation, for instance, basically because they know how to do business. Sometimes social workers, they don't know how to do business. So they think they're going to business and they want to sustain themselves. So they put 10 ringgit, they make 12 ringgit. They think it's a lot of money. They make untung 2 ringgit, you know. But the time they spend on the business kind of like affect their social work because, they, you know, like Allah give everybody strength in different areas. You know, some people may be good at doing business. Some people may be good at helping out people. So as such, if we, like I said, like Hannah said earlier, we within the house of Khadija, alhamdulillah, we have a good background of people from the corporate world, from the civil servant, from the, I know, the teachers, you know, those who guide us. And then we have the movers, the young one is the one who works lah, you know. So if we consolidate our capacity, our skills in terms of the corporate world, the civil servant, the teachers, the elders, and then us, that's how we consolidate lah. And inshallah, you know, like inshallah, if for me, like all these years I've been working with social work, if it happens, it happens, you know, because at the end, like when you want to do good, basically, if Allah, you know, God wants to give you a project, mean He wants you to be able to help someone, and that is a blessing. Kalau you tak dapat, mana you're not good enough for the blessing, or maybe Allah, you know, God is saying like, you know, like not now. Exactly, you know. So I know that, but you have that trust, you know. Of course, you work on it, lah. You just don't sit here and talk about it. You work on it. You meet people. And you build network. That's what the other thing that we're doing is our partnership. In terms of partnership, not only build our capacity financially, but also build our capacity as a skill as well, and our capacity to work with the social environment. So we need to partner with good other NGOs. I always believe in collaboration rather than competition. So we collaborate and we partnership. Those are also capacity building for us, you know. And through building networks, atau building this you know, silaturahim, they call it, or more like, you know, between people, it's where the openings come, because you meet more people,
right?
You know, and
connections,
you get more resources.
So alhamdulillah. So I mean, we welcome viewers who are organizations, partnerships, of course, kan, you can contact us or through our Facebook page and as well. And moving on, okay, sebelum tu, it's inappropriate for me kalau kita berada di satu tempat yang telah disajikan, kan. Kita nak shout out to Mr. Aman, Abdul Rahman and team, Izwan here, who graciously on a Sunday, you know, Sunday family day, yang datang sini, kan. Alhamdulillah. And kita nak iklan sikit lah. I mean, Muka is open from pukul 12 kan? From 12 to 9, and it's drive-through, pick up and go. So you can just order and set meal up for you, insyaAllah. So just like to get things clear lah, insyaAllah. So thank you very much, Muka and Mukabah. And moving onwards, I nak tahu especially tentang the work that you do, yang you pergi kepada tempat-tempat yang miskin bandar, maybe Chowkit ke Kota Damansara pun banyak. So boleh cerita sedikit tak apa pengalaman Hana?
Okay, terima kasih Din. Bila you cakap pasal pengalaman pergi tengok miskin bandar tu, saya rasa pengalaman saya memang tak sebanyak yang Mahdar experience, sebab saya sebelum dalam bidang industri seni ni, saya I was a reporter. Masa tu I work with a company untuk melaporkan dan membaca berita lah. So pretty much sometimes I'm on field dekat tempat-tempat kawasan seperti itu, and sometimes I can be dekat tingkat paling atas pejabat Perdana Menteri, kan. Tapi walau macam mana pun, daripada apa pendapatan saya, pengalaman saya itu insyaAllah lah sedikit sebanyak rasanya bolehlah membantu dalam apa ni mengembangkan lagi House of Saidah Khadijah. Macam mana kita nak engage golongan dekat luar sana, baik yang tua maupun yang muda, untuk sama-sama menyertai kita dalam NGO ini. Dan alhamdulillah, walaupun masa tu kita mulakan kempen, ingat tak dalam kempen pertama kita adalah mengedarkan food basket kan? Masya Allah, sambutan dia sangat-sangat-sangat-sangat menggalakkan daripada company dan juga orang perseorangan. Kita manage masa tu dapat mengedarkan lebih daripada 600 food basket kepada orang dekat luar sana. Food basket tu lebih kepada keperluan basic tau. Basic, macam beras, cili kering. Cili kering ni penting lah sebenarnya. Kalau tak ada cili kering, macam nak buat sambal? Orang kita tak makan sambal, tak puas babe. Tak makan nasi, betul tak? Jadi cili kering, bawang dan sebagainya, kentang, kita edarkan kepada lebih daripada 600 buah keluarga, Masya Allah. Dan terutamalah shout out juga kepada apa ni JK sebab memberi sumbangan yang sangat, Masya Allah, orang-orang perseorangan yang dengan tanpa kata berfikir dua kali lah. Kita minta, Masya Allah, terus. Dan saya rasa berterima kasih jugalah sebab ahli-ahli House of Saidah Khadijah ni, mereka ni banyak connection. Masya Allah, Alhamdulillah kan. Tapi instead of mereka ni duduk saja, tapi mereka rasa perlu untuk mereka membantu dekat luar sana menggunakan connection yang mereka ada ni untuk membantu mereka yang memerlukan. So saya tak kata saya ni pakar ataupun ahli sebab saya rasa memang bagi pada mahandalah. Tapi saya memang dah niatkan. Masa saya masuk House of Saidah Khadijah ni, apa yang boleh saya buat yang saya nak khidmat walaupun saya tak maaf cakap lah, saya ni bodoh tak tahu apa-apa sebenarnya.
Dalam kapasiti sendiri lah.
Wallahi memang tak pandai langsung. Tapi saya belajar insyaAllah. Sebab kalau saya rasa kalau kita set kita punya niat tu betul, insyaAllah Allah akan buka jalan.
Amin. Okay, sorry buat pause. Fikir ni. Boleh tak kita nak fikir?
Deep ke?
Penyampaian tu, penyampaian tu amat, it goes far-fetched lah. Bukan hanya kita fikirkan keadaan sekarang, kita fikirkan keadaan yang 3 tahun tadi, apa yang akan jadi, especially during pandemic ni, bilakah COVID ni akan when is this story going to end?
Betul. Tapi Din, boleh tak saya tambah bila boleh. Cakap pasal orang fikir pasal pandemik ni kan? Saya teringat kata-kata ustazah saya, Ustazah Azmi Mansur, memang sangat baik dengan saya, Masya Allah. Dia kata, Hana, benda-benda yang akan datang ni kita tak perlu risau. Masalah yang kita ada ni, kita hadapi je lah. Kita hadap, yolah. Dia kata.
Jalan terus.
Hadap, yolah. Yang nak fikir tu tak apa. Itu biar Allah yang uruskan semua. Kita apa yang kita ada ni, kita usahakan. Mana yang kita boleh tolong, kita tolong. Kita support each other. Kalau tak nak support secara kewangan, kita support secara kerohanian. Tak support secara kerohanian, kita support dengan beri kata motivasi. Dan kita spread goodness lah. Sebab saya rasa too much negativity
betul,
outside.
Betul.
Be outside. Tapi saya rasa lebih kepada social media. Dan bila kita ni consume banyak sangat social media. Sebab saya percaya dalam musim PKP, orang tak nak buat apa. Orang asyik tengok phone je.
Betul.
So when kita hadap benda tu, kita kena juga contribute benda yang baik dalam social media kita. So bila orang duk hadap benda-benda negatif, otak mereka pun akan jadi sedih tau. Dia akan rasa anxiety dan sebagainya. So kita ni perlu kita perlu bertindak dengan kita juga spread positivity. Kalau kita tak boleh nak spread benda-benda baik, kita diam saja sudah. Sebab kita tak faham kadang-kadang situasi orang. They have different shoes. Kita tak boleh nak berada dalam situasi mereka betul. Semua. So kita kena just be kind aja. If you not do anything, just be kind. Especially on social media.
Jalan terus lah. Jalan terus lah.
Jalan terus. Hadap yo. Madasik
whether you like it or
hadap
not.
Hadap yo. Cita dia.
Jalan terus lah. It's here. And so we do the best we can with what we have. And most importantly, the youth and anak-anak kita, macam mana kita nak hadapi psychologically they are terkesan. Especially like my daughter is taking SPM. Hanan, if you are watching this, I hope that dalam suasana pandemik ni, Hanan be strong, sabar, apa saja keadaan, whatever is SPM is not end all, kan? I mean, I'm here for you, the whole family is here for you. So begitu juga dengan family Mahdar and next, you know, it's about to get together as a family, and that is what House of Sayyidah Khadijah stands for, to get everyone to do goodness, to spread goodness. All right, so I want to hear actually the stories that on the field. Maybe like it's not kita bukan just give saja, but kita mendalami apa masalah kita take kita ambil perhatian tentang masalah keluarga dia, apa yang dia perlukan. Kita nak ta'aruf, I mean kita nak berkenalan dengan keluarga. It's not just like give and then go. No, it's just it's a long term process. It's a connection that transcends more than that. So probably you like to tell a story.
No story, yeah. But I mean, story ini sometimes like when we start doing social work, there is a pitfall that that we have to be aware and wary of. That we think we are the upper hand. Kita tangan yang memberi. In actual fact, we are also the lower hand. Maknanya, they call it, okay, kalau in English, it's called true servanthood. True servanthood. In fact, very interesting. I was exposed to this refined social work ni at a church punya gathering where they train their youth to work in social work, and they were talking about the term true servanthood versus self-righteous servanthood. So and I fell into that self-righteous. So I think I was the helping hand. I was the better one. You know, so like people need me. Actually, we need them. You know, and we need them because mungkin Allah openkan or God opens us to help other people as a penance. We all have issues, you know, individually, as a family, as a society, as a country, we have issues. Our issues is just different, but the difficulty is the same. You know, so when I go out, for instance, to give like basic food, rice, sugar, you know, so those people are in need of that. But I've seen people who are in need of that and they live in the low cost flats, you know, we call it PPR kan, yang paling rendah ni, but they were happy. I wasn't as happy as them, and they, you know, they were happy. They were happy with what they don't have, and I was complaining with, and I'm still doing complaining about what I have. And also that is like a lesson. And maybe when we do go out, this is more for us to, for me lah, personally, is to be reminded. And then balik lupa lah after a few days. You know, lupa. And then you start complaining again about the things that you have. That I have, not you. You know. Tapi, you know, there is a lot of difficulty. And in fact, in this pandemic, you know, it's not just the people at young PPR tau. Even the middle class. Yang dulu ada kerja, sekarang tak ada kerja. Yang dulu business okay, sekarang tak business. Actually, tapi this category of people, actually, because diorang not in that category, so diorang segan nak minta. For them to receive a food pack tu, diorang macam segan. Tapi they are in need. I know they are in need. But now a lot of them are opening up as well. Diorang pun, you know, and I think difficulty punya story tu, it's the same for everybody lah. It's just, it manifests in different ways. You know, the things that they don't have, you have. The things that you have, they have, you don't have. You know, so, tapi, again, you know, like personally, when we do social work as an individual or as a collective or organization, is, you know, there's two ways to look at it. You know, one side of the coin is because you are healthy within and it manifests out that you help people. For me, it's more because I'm not healthy within. Maybe because this helping people will make me healthy. Maybe this is my only bargaining chip lah. Ada orang kata, this guy helped. You know, how come he be damned? You know, he helped me. You know, so there's always two ways. You know, like you look at it. You know, for me, is I'm going out there to help people that it may bersihkan my wrong. You know, and help me with my difficulties if I help others. So I think with you also I mentioned in that you have to remind me, we have to remind each other of that. You know, it's not that, you know, like we have to remind each other that we need this. rather than we are giving this out to people in need.
It's always a challenge. People, we help ourselves as well. It's two-way.
In a way, you think, oh, you're helping yourself, macam selfish kan? You're actually helping yourself by helping people kan? But no, it's like I say, it's two sides of the coin. Some people, their heart are nurtured. They, mashallah, you know, their mashallah means like Allah protect their heart because their heart is nurtured. So with that good heart, they go out and help people. With me, more like helping people in the hope that that will fix my heart when I help people.
Anak cakap sama, high five, okay. Sama lah kita.
Alhamdulillah, dalam suasana ni pun kita as tergerak dengan seorang individu ni lah. Just Ustaz Abid Liu kan, Ustaz Abid Liu in his capacity kan, he's done a lot even to help in his capacity. Masya Allah. Kita pun dalam suasana ini kita buat apa yang kita boleh dengan apa yang kita mampu. Bukan yang kita nak harapkan kita nak buat macam dia ke apa ke. Masya Allah, dengan sekecil-kecil membantu seseorang yang di tepi jalan beli air mineral water tu pun it's a blessing for him. Dah satu hari dia mungkin dah lama dia tak minum dahaga. And then don't take benda-benda kecil tu, it's actually sebenarnya beneficial. So you do what you can with what you have, and alhamdulillah House of Sayyidah Khadijah also stands for that. We would like to learn more about maybe you have Muslimat yang mendengar ke, maybe you have programs for Muslimat and what not, insyaallah ustazah.
Okay, insyaallah. Sebenarnya ialah banyak perancangan daripada House of Sayyidah Khadijah, terutama daripada Division Youth lah, JY Youth Division. We call ourselves Youth Division lah, insyaAllah kan. Antaranya, insyaAllah, kalaulah PKP ni is lifted after 4 Februari eh? 2 Februari ke? 4 ke 2? 4th of February, insyaAllah. Kita nak buat majlis dekat sini. Okay, antaranya adalah kita... Antaranya ini antara majlis yang kita cuba nak lakukan lah. Macam sharing session kan, bersama-sama dengan inspirers, figura-figura yang boleh memberi motivasi dan inspirasi kepada orang dekat luar sana. So insyaAllah this is going to be like a monthly thing. Tapi insyaAllah with a much entertaining punya style lah. So the idea is to have like a small band. Sebab Mahdar pun daripada Caravan of Praise kan, kita berhibur yang mengingatkan kita kepada Allah dan juga Rasul. Kan, sambil-sambil kita berhibur tu, kita belajar sesuatu yang boleh memberi suntikan jiwa dan rohani kita juga. Dan kita akan memberi support pada each other while we are doing that. So kita punya perancangan adalah untuk juga menemu ramah individu-individu, bukan saja dekat Malaysia, bukan saja selebriti dekat KL saja, tapi figura-figura daripada international. Contohkan what we have in mind tu, saya nak sangat sebenarnya to bring in Sir Peter Sanders. Sir Peter Sanders ni merupakan seorang photographer yang Masya Allah sangat hebat and has worked with a lot of Masya Allah individual, bukan setakat figura-figura agama antarabangsa tetapi juga orang lain juga, ikon-ikon lain juga kan. Dan diiktiraf sebenarnya kerja beliau itu oleh Queen Elizabeth sendiri. Kan? Kalau tak nak letakkan nama dia Sir kan? Kat depan tu kan? Jadi saya nak sangat untuk melihat sisi seni dia. Dan saya rasa ini boleh menarik juga minat anak-anak muda yang mungkin berminat dengan seni, yang mereka nak kembangkan bakat seni mereka ke arah kebaikan dan ke arah menyumbang balik kepada komuniti nanti insyaAllah. Membina juga kerjaya mereka dan menyumbang balik kepada komuniti. InsyaAllah, that's in the pipeline. Kita also ada juga perancangan untuk menemui ramai lagi sebenarnya figura-figura ni kan. InsyaAllah kita akan cuba lakukan sesi seperti ini setiap bulan kan, Idin kan? Kita nak bawa, you know, band-band yang berbakat, Masya Allah, yang boleh kompos lagu-lagu mengingatkan kita kepada Tuhan, mengingatkan kita kepada Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, kan? Dan juga tokoh-tokoh agama lain lah, Insya Allah. Itu antara perancangannya lah. Selain daripada itu, Insya Allah, concernnya juga kita akan buat sesi budah secara online. Budah ni sebenarnya merupakan syair ataupun syair yang ditulis oleh Imam Busiri memuji Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Jadi kita nak mengkaji sebenarnya keindahan puisi tersebut dari aspek seni dan bagaimana puisi ini boleh membantu menyegarkan jiwa-jiwa yang gersang, yang sangat memerlukan kasih dan sayang tu, insyaallah dengan barakah budaya itu boleh membantu mereka sebenarnya. Dan tengok juga aspek seni Islam tu sendiri, sebab cantiknya bahasa puisi yang ditulis oleh Imam Busiri ini kan, sampaikan letaklah apa lagu pun jalan baik boleh kalau kita nyanyikan kasidah ni. Jadi tu antara perancangannya lah. Kita nak buat secara online dahulu. Kalau insyaAllah kalau PKP ni lifted, kita akan buat kelas syarah mengenai kasidah budah di sini insyaAllah. Itu antara perancangannya lah for a start. Tapi kalau anda ada cadangan lain yang boleh kita lakukan untuk membantu anak-anak muda dekat luar sana, please, kita memang, you guys are always welcome untuk beri contribution kepada kita dekat sini, because kita dah ada dah, Masya Allah, location yang sangat-sangat Masya Allah ni, yang cool and hip ni, sambil-sambil kita belajar boleh order makan. Boleh order kopi, you know. Ha, kan? Masya Allah, tempat ni tempat ibadah yang memang sangat-sangat selesa, so you guys are always welcome.
Nak tanya Mahda tadi tentang, because Mahda as we being a role in Caravan of Praise. Kalau siapa tak tahu Caravan of Praise ni, dia banyak buat events, musical art, poetry. So how does art, if you want nak assimilate dengan the work, this work that of House of Sayyidah Khadijah, how do you think that art can, we can work together?
Right. Okay, personally I'm not an artistic person myself. I'm not an artist, I'm a musician. No, but I like music. I love music. I've always grew up loving music. Music has always inspired me. Sometimes before the lyrics inspire me, the melody inspire me first, and then I like the lyric. Sometimes it's the other way around. Tapi not just music. Tapi because I, besides House of Kharijah, like you said, mentioned Crescent Collective, I've always used arts as a medium for my program. Because I'm working with the young people, and the young people, even my generation, not so young, but we still, are very audio and visual kind of generation, especially nowadays with the mobile phone. Yeah, because people don't hold books anymore. I mean, that's a reality. Last time you can see people say, oh, I cannot read a PDF, or I cannot read an e-book. It's very difficult. But now people are getting used to it. Mm-hmm. And also more people are, like TikTok, this TikTok generation, it's all about music and visual. And also everybody is publishing their own art, so to say, again. Mm-hmm. Tapi it's, we have to use the medium. If it's a working medium, you have Jalan Lama or you have the highway. So it's up to you. You can use Jalan Lama, it's going to reach there longer, it's more tiring, or you can use the highway and reach there faster. So if that works, that works. And maybe now it's arts, music, and visual. Maybe in the future it's not. So we have to just be dynamic and change towards that. Because what is important is the message, or what is important is the substance that we want to pass. Mm-hmm. And the medium, could be anything. So at the moment, the medium is a lot of arts, music. Young people like that. So of course, I bring a lot of and for me also, the artists are very critical because they are very influential. Mm-hmm. Nowadays you have this term influencers.
Influencers,
influencers. Sometimes you might be a managing director, but influencer ni lagi banyak follower than managing director. You make more money as influencer, because you have more followers. So influencer becomes a job title now. But with that comes responsibility, because who are you influencing? How many people you're influencing, and what are you influencing them with? I wouldn't take that. I work with artists who are influenced, in Caravan of Praise. I feel sorry for them. You guys have a lot of responsibility. And whatever you do, people follow. If you don't inspire them, right? But alhamdulillah, all these artists, they're inspiring people. And they use their position as artists, as musician. They realize that and they use that to inspire people. And they try, they try. And it comes with all the challenges, because artists also have to survive. And, especially this time of pandemic, a lot of our artists are struggling because they don't have events, they don't have shows. Some of the artists are, need help, need actually help, bantuan-bantuan, because they are not the people yang can survive without shows. Exactly, but they're still producing.
you know, they're still producing, they're still going online, they still try to inspire a lot of young people, you know, and a lot of people sometimes inspired by some of the stories they sell, you know, or some of the stories they share, not sell, not the music they sell, but the stories that they share. So music and art plays an important role. So it not necessarily be music as well, you know, visual artist like Hana, about photographer. And I've seen Peter Sanders work. In fact, the first time he came here, I was part of the organization. He came with Hamza Yusof and Yusof Islam. And he did a presentation of his book under the shade of the tree or something like that. And it was a story. Every photo that he put out there was a story, and it was an inspirational story. You know, about his travel to Mauritania, the photos that he took in Mauritania of how people live there. And I still remember some of the stories, you know, from that photo, because it's very inspirational. So we use this. You know, we use this to inspire people. Because, you know, like, kita pun bukan kata orang muda. Kita yang tua ni pun, bila we sit too long in a lecture, in a talk, we don't last that long. You know, we get, you know, tired of it. I mean, not tired of that, it's just naturally, again. So, sometimes we need, like, macam ni, a very short, inspiring moment. And that could happen a lot with the artist. So I work with this artist, I say like, no, Alhamdulillah, you should say it's a blessing that a lot of people love you. Macam Hana ni semua kan. Kalau dia cakap dia sakit dalam dia punya Instagram, anda tengok berapa orang doakan dia. Hana kau dapat 5 orang doakan, sudah bagus. If 5 people doa for me, tapi for her kan, Masya Allah. Oh, may you get well, may you get near. And this is same with Andy Flock Poppy, Adib. I said, you guys are blessed because a lot of people love you. And love is what God puts in the heart of people, though. You cannot force that.
It's a blessing in disguise because you boleh. Terima kasih. Because being an influencer, artist especially, a lot of people look up you. Even the kids. Even my daughter look up. Ultimate ke kan, contohlah kan, Andy ke, tengok main longboard, I shoot, ui, kan, I mean those are the icons that. But what message do you portray? Do you portray a good message, or do you portray what intentions do you want as an influencer? So it's very important for you, or for me as well. I'm not an influencer lah. Apa ni, to actually spread good things in social media, especially betul sekarang Mada cakap kan, social media plays a very main role lah sekarang ni, especially bangun aja the first thing that we ni biasanya is phone, mana-mana kita bawa phone. So good to actually time yourself or time your family to phone my time bila makan ke apa ke, because it connects us together physically rather than virtually. So the feeling is different. The feeling is different. Macam sekarang ni, the feeling is different. Normally when I do, I don't know whether you guys know that I'm doing Nasi Lemak Chronicles talk show. Short sendiri lah ni. Buat sendiri kan, interview Mada pun ada, mana belum lagi lah. So the feeling is different when you and another person that you're interviewing is in another part, as opposed to I can see you physically here. It's memang different lah. So but nak buat macam mana, this is the norm that we have to go. So insyaAllah May this pandemic or may this problem, this situation get better and better and better, inshallah. So if there is any questions, guys, or viewers, if there's any question, please write down. Nanti saya tengok ada tak question ke apa. Sementara tu, okay. Rata-rata penonton yang respon positif, thank you very much. Dia setuju dengan banyak yang dikatakan. Nak engage you to be engaged as well. It's not just the three of us. You are also involved. So please share your comments or whatever that you like to say. Please share in the comment section. And question nanti kita tengok. Okay. Ada soalan daripada viewer. Bagaimana untuk kekalkan semangat untuk terus memberi khidmat bantuan supaya emosi jadi tak putus asa? Bagus ni soalan ni. Bagaimana kita nak kekalkan semangat untuk terus memberi khidmat bantuan supaya emosi jadi tak putus asa, especially in these trying times? So, siapa rasa nak ambil this question? Can, no problem. Open. Open to the floor.
Baiklah, okay, insyaAllah saya cuba jawab sehabis baiklah, sebab saya pun masih baru lagi dalam apa ni kerja-kerja ni. Tapi saya rasa it's very important for you to get in the right circle. Maksud saya get in the right circle support ni, kawan-kawan you siapa? Choose your friends wisely. Siapa you punya circle tu? If you don't have that kind of circle, you boleh initiate. But if you rasa you tak boleh ada kemampuan untuk initiate that kind of circle to help, you pergi kepada circle yang boleh, yang sentiasa bekerja dengan bidang-bidang seperti ini, insyaAllah. Because it's always important to choose the right circle. Macam saya, Alhamdulillah, of course lah, first kita kena set kita punya intention right, yang pertama. Yang pertama, yeah, set kita punya intention right. Niat kita untuk tolong tu sebenarnya untuk apa? Adakah kerana Allah? Adakah kerana nak dapatkan nama? Mungkin juga kita tak tahu kan, tapi kena betulkan niat. So bila niat itulah yang akan menjadi drive you, walaupun you dalam keadaan yang paling-paling down, paling-paling bawah. So niat tu is a very good drive untuk you teruskan kerja-kerja khidmah you. Kedua, you have to be in the circle lah, in a good circle. Make doa, make doa, dan kita akan berada dalam circle yang bagus. Ya Allah, letakkan aku dalam kumpulan-kumpulan orang yang engkau redai, yang engkau sayangi, yang membuat kerja ke arah kebaikan, insyaAllah. So bila you dah minta buat niat tu, you dah minta doa kepada Allah, insyaAllah Allah akan letak you dalam jalan yang dia nak, insyaAllah. So that's the two things yang I mula-mula initiate bila I nak buat. Kalau betul lah aku nak berkhidmat ni, aku nak khidmatkan engkau ya Allah. Yang kedua, letakkan aku dalam kumpulan orang yang sentiasa membuat kerja untuk engkau, insyaAllah. Dan Alhamdulillah, saya rasa macam dalam tak sedar, tiba-tiba saya dah dalam grup Saidah Khadijah. So Saidah Khadijah
macam family
pula. Allah, eh, macam. And then Alhamdulillah, semuanya dalam fikrah yang sama pula tu. So memang it's important to make that niat and a doa. So niat yang betul dan doa, insyaAllah. Then get yourself in the right circle. So three things. Yeah.
Very important to touch about intentions. I was just actually driving just now and Chef Fudin mentioned about talk about the intentions. Macam-macam intentions you to nak buat jahat pun intention juga. To maybe one day I would like to bring kita kumpul duit one day nak bawa isteri ataupun anak bapa dengan mak ke umrah, insyaAllah. So those are intentions. So you start with intention, insyaAllah you follow through lah. So kekalkan semangat anda, insyaAllah things will go better. Okay, wah, pandai pula cakap. Okay, so let's see the next question. Thank you so much. By the way, viewers, siapa yang dah post questions and siapa yang dah komen, tak sempat nak tengok komen. So the next question is, okay, apa nasihat kepada mereka yang mahu melibatkan diri dalam khidmat sosial dan kerja amal? Dari mana mereka patut mula? Where beginning? Where should they start? I mean, the best in the beginning kan? Dah jadi ini.
In the beginning, masya Allah.
So how, kalau katakan baru kan, tapi dia berminat. So, dia nak start macam mana?
You can, benda ni not really structured though. Because for me as well, when I started, it wasn't that I wanted to plan to do social work. I was actually working in advertising. And then I work in a private school, and then somehow I work in a software company. My background early on has always been advertising and marketing lah.
I see.
And then I end up social work, and I was inspired. My social work is inspired by an Indian Hindu guy.
Oh yeah.
A Hindu lawyer inspired me to do social work because of his selflessness. So I was like, man, you know, like someone who could achieve luxury in his life but give it up to help those who need help, litigation, lawyers help, legal aid, kan? So I was one of the person he helped, lah. So I always remember him, because you need to look whatever you do. When I look, how did I end up like this? What I'm doing?
I need to look the person that inspired me kan. I believe that is the genealogy of gratitude. Who inspired me? Even though inspiration sekejap je. Tapi yang those who train me into doing social work is different people. And I spend more time with them. But that guy inspired me from the start. So if you're inspired, just see what you can do. Hmm. You know, in our tradition, makan-makan, you know, the prophecy, even kalau you ambil satu batu daripada jalan tu, it's a charity. It's a mile, it's a charity. Kan? You can start with that lah. There's a lot of, you know, like some people, all they need is a smile. Mm. And I also would like, you know, one of the early training that, you know, that somebody taught me to do social work is that you go to the homeless and the vagrants, kan? Orang-orang tepi jalan ni. Mm. Just give them a smile and ask them how they're doing. Because last time I bought, one of the things that I start early on is this kind of like soup kitchen. Kan? Oh, soup orang kitchen. Makan. At that time we call it food not bombs.
I heard that.
So, budak-budak Central Market lah. And so I would join that. Kena kasih. But yeah, these people, orang kasih makan and then they walk away. So somebody told me, you know, like a lot of people are giving food already. Mm-hmm. So why don't you just ask them, how are you? Because the world passes by them macam don't exist. Mm-hmm. For them to be asked how they are doing that day tu.
Just a friendly gesture.
It's a huge thing. Then when I try it, when I did that exercise, I can see their face change. And when I was in Penang, this guy, when I asked him what's his name, so dia minta belanja makan, so belanja dia makan lah, so I tanya dia, and then when I asked his name, tengok muka dia macam marah. So I was, you know, sometimes lah, vagrant ni, kita tak tahu dia punya reaction macam mana kan. But what affected him is like, then he says, I said, kenapa? You marah ke apa? Then, nobody has asked me my name for many years. Because nobody care what my name is. But I have a name. My father gave me a name. Nobody asked. They gave me food, but they don't ask me my name. You ask my name, dia terkejut. Macam, apa sah kau nak tahu nama aku kan? What does it matter to you? Of course lah, aku nak belanja kau makan. At least I want to know your name. I have somebody to refer, a name to put on the face down the years kan? So his name is Rahman. But it's actually, it's a Hindu name. He gave me a Rahman name because dia takut kalau dia kasih nama India, I tak tolong dia. But I say, okay, I forget it. I still gonna remember you as Rahman because that's the first name you gave me. But you can start small. You can start small and then, you know, find a course that you like, an organization that's doing that. And then just start slowly. You don't need to, like, you know, go big. Start within your neighborhood. You know, you tengok neighborhood you, ada tak macam orang miskin? Orang yang memerlukan? You know, then you can start with that. You know, just going back to the point yang macam, but you know, that yang earlier tu. How do you carry on?
How do you sustain semangat?
It is difficult. I got burnt out. There were 1 year I didn't do anything. I kind of like even like get frustrated with society. I said, like, I'm going to fix myself. Society can fix themselves. But then, you
up
know,
to that point, then, up, to that,
up
point.
To that point, because you're working with people and you know, like it or not, it's very hard not to take it personally because it's social work. You're dealing with people's emotion. It becomes something, it becomes personal. So but while I was in America, alhamdulillah, I was blessed to be sent for a few weeks training in America, and I met this father Gregory Boyle. He runs a social organization in South Central LA where he rehabilitated these gang violence people, the Crips and the Blood. And I was fortunate to ask him a question. We had 5 minutes with him. They call him Father G lah, so ni semua gangster kan. Father G. Tapi so I asked him. And he have built this organization very well until it becomes cool. All the Hollywood actors must start coming to the organization to help. And I asked him, how do you sustain this? Because I get burnt out. And he gave a quote, and it was actually his quote, but he answered me like that. And it's very beautiful. It's so inspiring and profound. He said, we have a God who waits. And who are we not to wait? It takes what it takes for the big turnaround. Just wait. So yeah, this basically is just carry on. Again, he's telling you, it's not about the result. It's about your effort. Because you get frustrated because you want result. Kita become result-oriented, not effort-oriented. That keeps me going. Just tunggu lah. Because in fact, kalau Allah wants, you know, if the way we are, if God were to punish us, we would have been punished. We don't carry ourselves well. We don't help people. We don't, you know, like we. My father used to say, if you can't do good, don't do bad. So I'm kind of like, I do bad. So
So maybe I'm doing good trying to erase my bad. You know, Allahu a'lam, you know.
Same here. Kita nak clean our sins, insyaAllah, as best as we can. So, up to the next question, tengok macam mana. We still have time, insyaAllah. Okay. Jika ada yang nak memberi bantuan atau ingin menyumbang, tenaga ke? Ataupun tenaga lah kepada host Khadijah, bagaimana caranya mereka nak contact host Khadijah?
Okay. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Sebenarnya kalau niat untuk menjadi ahli, just DM saja kami di Facebook ataupun DM kami di Instagram. Dan kalau anda kenal individu-individu yang terlibat dalam Hasul Sayyidah Khadijah, contohnya saya, contohnya Idin, contohnya Mahda dan yang lain-lain, anda boleh terus saja DM mereka. Yeah. InsyaAllah kami akan bantu, kami akan assist you guys from there. Dan kalau anda berminat untuk menyumbang mungkin dari aspek tenaga ataupun bantuan yang secara fizikal, kan, boleh juga DM kami dan kami akan sentiasa akan update sebenarnya apa bentuk projek yang kita akan lakukan from time to time. Jadi just make sure that you guys make sure that korang update on your social media on Facebook and on Instagram and just wait lah kita punya announcement seterusnya, insyaAllah.
Do click on notification so that you be notified as and when we do have our whatever events that we have. And next question from ni ada nama ni, Loli Kamaruddin. Soalan dia, boleh saya suggest, can we extend our moral support to golongan istimewa? Golongan istimewa, ramai family out there yang ada anak-anak istimewa need moral support, especially rohani dan jasmani. Mereka sangat memerlukan perlu pengisian ilmu. I think it's very important as well, golongan istimewa ni, sebab kita tak terpinggir golongan istimewa. They need help as well. They are humans like we are, my relative ada yang anak-anak istimewa. How dia dengan kesabaran dia mengajar dan mendidik anak istimewa ni untuk, you know, it's a caring society. You must have a caring heart, especially in the family sense. Apalagi time-time COVID macam ni, kan. So insyaAllah, maybe if we can cook up something, insyaAllah, for this segment. It's very important as well. Terima kasih, Puan Loli. The next one.
Thank you, Puan Loli Kamran. It's a good question. It's a good suggestion. Sorry, not question. It's a good suggestion. Memang, like I said, that's important that we have internal capacity building. Because golongan-golongan istimewa ni perlu istimewa punya skill juga. So the way we build skill is either internally we build our capacity or kita partnership with those who are already into that, you know, and we support them what they need. For instance, golongan istimewa, children, even orang tua. My mother is suffering with dementia. My sister is 24/7 carer. And it's a difficult task, not just for her, but even for my sister to look after. We've been talking about a few projects with my sister, if not taken off yet. When we have partnership, we have more resources. And then for instance, Loli Kamaruddin, if that is your interest, if that is your passion, you know, the golongan istimewa, so we can build our capacity. But first, we need to build that capacity. Like, we have to know. Like, me myself right now is still learning about dementia because my mother is having dementia, and it's a difficult set of skill to learn. And, you know, the psychology of it. Well, alhamdulillah, my sister has been very diligent and very I have a lot of conviction. So she learned a lot and she's sharing with us. And I know a few friends and a few relatives, young, their elders are already going into dementia. You know, and this is the people who also special, because not just in their condition, but they're special to us. They are our elders, you know, and this few years of their life to give them the best quality of life before they go again. Thank you for the suggestion. Inshallah, if you know, you can get in touch with us. You can even like spearhead that initiative, you know.
Siapa out there, the viewers, siapa yang ada pengalaman dengan golongan istimewa ni, you can share with us or will contact us. So maybe kita boleh work something out. Very important jangan lupa dengan golongan istimewa, sebab keistimewaan diorang akan it's cerminan kepada kita punya kita punya hati terhadap diorang. So yeah, thank you very much for that insightful suggestion. Okay, saranan daripada penonton is very important as well supaya kita sentiasa ingatkan diri kita dalam kerja membuat amal kita dan juga organisasi atau pertubuhan yang lain. Siapa sajalah mungkin dalam buat amal ke ataupun siapa yang terdedah, contohnya rider Grab, runner, ever, to always take care, patuhi SOP keselamatan diri, make sure that you be guided from harm, you be defended from harm. Pakai mask, jangan lupa sanitizer. If you have a small sanitizer, just put it in your pocket, your bag, and make sure that if your daughter goes to school, please advise every day. Jangan tired, advise every day so that they will care for them. Because if you care for your family, you have to care for yourself lah. So siapa yang selalu keluar buat kerja amal tu, please take care dalam because kita dealing dengan orang juga kan. So it's very important to have that system supaya kita tak kena pada kita lah, maknanya. Dalam nak buat baik jadi harm lah kan. So so kena berjaga-jaga lah, especially in this time macam Selangor kan. Tapi alhamdulillah as we also play an important role to make sure that everything is taken care of in a way selamat, dan supaya bila kita balik kita pun family kita selamat, dalam keadaan selamat lah, insyaAllah. So doakan eh. And ada lagi ya? Okay, soalan seterusnya ya. Okay, adakah host Khadijah juga ada perancangan untuk mengunjurkan bantuan kepada golongan M40? Okay, siapa kan yang rasa terpanggil untuk nak jawab soalan ni? Probably, eh?
Okay, terima kasih. Sebenarnya tadi telah pun dimention oleh Mahdar, memang golongan M40 juga merupakan antara golongan sasar kita, bukan setakat B40 saja. Sebab macam yang Mahdar katakan tadi, sebenarnya semakin banyak golongan M40 ini yang mereka mungkin sebelum ini mereka mempunyai perusahaan terpaksa tutup. Mereka mempunyai pekerjaan. Contoh macam pilot, banyak mereka yang tak ada pekerjaan lagi sebab apa? Airline tak memerlukan mereka, khidmat mereka lagi sebab tak boleh nak terbang dan sebagainya. So ini antara benda yang kita look into juga. Jadi dan bila Mahdar kata sebenarnya semakin banyak golongan ini yang mula membuka mulut untuk meminta bantuan dan sebagainya. Ya, memang betul, M40 juga merupakan antara golongan sesar kita, dan sebenarnya sesiapa sahajalah dekat luar sana yang memerlukan bantuan mahupun dari aspek bekalan makanan ke suntikan rohani dan semangat ke apa semuanya, memang kita insyaAllah kita akan tolong dengan sedaya upaya kita lah. Sebab saya pun faham, kita pun memang, kita juga pun struggle juga at the same time kan. Jadi dengan cara membantu orang tu insyaAllah mungkin Allah akan bantu kita juga. So we will try to help as much as we can, as best as we can insyaAllah, within our capacity insyaAllah.
Alhamdulillah, yeah, that's one of our efforts that we have in mind. Okay, ada, I don't know, from your friend or maybe kenalan kan, Nini Zulkifli, dia tak ada question but dia nak thank Mahdar and Hana Ismail. You two never fail to inspire me, Masya Allah. So so yeah, dalam memberi apa ni, memberi tahniah ke, I mean kita always have in mind that kadang-kadang kita kena jaga hati juga kan. Especially Mahdar always teaches me in his own way not to actually, if you dapat terima compliment kan, sometimes we lupa kan, we lupa diri apa semua, kita ujuk ke ada apa semua kan. So So thank you very much for that as well. So you, it, they don't, do not only inspire you, they inspire me as well. Alhamdulillah. So these two great people here, alhamdulillah. So apa ni, if there are no questions, I think apa ni, just final summary lah. I mean, ini individu daripada latar belakang yang berbeza, macam Hana dengan Mada, mungkin nak cerita sikit background dan macam mana boleh terlibat dan tersentuh hati untuk probably you say that you inspired kan, so how do you or what touches you to actually keep on going with House of Saidah Khadijah ni? Apa yang terdetik di hati untuk that you feel is very important that you be a part of it and bagi bantuan, bagi usaha, bagi doa, bagi support, bagi kasih sayang dan sebagainya. What makes you have that touches your heart? Ana, maybe.
Okay. Saya tak pastilah kalau cerita saya ni boleh memberi inspirasi kepada sesiapa pun, tapi saya cuma nak berkongsi lah kan. Sebab alhamdulillah saya berada dalam industri apa ni, broadcasting ni, entertainment sejak 2012. Berapa lama dah 2012. Lama jugalah, alhamdulillah. Inilah saya rasa mungkin ruang rezeki yang Allah bagi untuk saya kan ketika itu. Dan sudah 8 tahun kot berkhidmat ya dengan syarikat, satu syarikat ini. Alhamdulillah telah membuka banyak peluang dan ruang kepada saya untuk mengembangkan bakat saya pada ketika itu. Tapi dalam pada saya bekerja untuk diri sendiri, tak pernah fikir macam mana kita nak contribute ke, tak fikir, because bila masuk umur kita 20s, macam mana kita nak kembangkan kita punya career, macam kita nak stable and whatnot. I guess that's a normal fasa dalam kehidupan pun. Memang semua orang mungkin mengalami fasa yang lebih kurang sama. Kalau mereka ada kesedaran awal, Masya Allah, alhamdulillah, good for you. Itu rezeki yang Allah bagi kan untuk you, rasa kesedaran untuk memberi kepada orang pada peringkat awal. Di masa tu, benda tu tak terlintas di fikiran saya. Tapi apa yang saya tahu masa tu, saya nak kembangkan bakat saya dan saya nak teruskan kehidupan saya. Macam mana saya nak membayar hutang dan komitmen-komitmen saya kepada ketika itu. Hinggalah pada Julai 2019, saya dijemput oleh sahabat saya, sahabat selebriti saya untuk Ihana. Jom kita berkumpul nak dekat muka, because ada a friend of ours ni, selebriti juga, dia dah berhijab tau. Jom kita bagi support dekat dia nak. So itulah mula permulaan. Saya berkumpul di muka ni, di mana selebriti-selebriti ni berkumpul, berkongsi cerita hijab mereka, cerita hijrah mereka. Maksud saya terdetik, sampai bila saya nak dalam situasi ni, walaupun saya dah berhijab, Masya Allah, tapi apa lagi yang saya boleh buat ya untuk to please my Lord, to please Rasulullah SAW, apa lagi yang boleh buat? So pada sejak dari tu dah mula rasa sesuatu lompong dalam hati saya. Dan mula rasa tak sedap, pergi kerja rasa tak best. Macam, apa lagi yang rasa macam kosong lah. Tak ada benda yang boleh saya nak look forward to in life. Jadi sedikit demi sedikit benda tu dah mula timbul. Kemudian bila saya pergi ke majlis yang terletak di Sungai Pencala. Nama majlis ni di Taufik . Mula melazimi majlis tersebut. Dan mula saya melazimi majlis. Masa tu terdetik, boleh best juga kalau saya menziarah family sebelah ibu saya di Zari masa tu kan. Jadi seorang sahabat saya ni, Kak Irma Fatimah, dia ajak Ihana, jom nak kita pergi Tarim nak, Hana. Ajak macam tu tau. Saya macam, saya dulu masa 2014 saya pernah beli tiket tau nak ke Tarim, nak jenguk saudara mana saya dekat sana, nak jenguk pakcik saya. Tapi because the war broke out, so I had to postpone the plan. Dah beli tiket dah masa tu. Tapi mungkinlah memang saya rasa everything is in Allah's time kan. Jadi penghujung 2019 saya membuat perancangan untuk ke Tarim. Januari saya Januari macam tu, dan dekat Februari saya pun pergi ke sana dengan tak ada pekerjaan. Masa tu saya tak sambung lagi kontrak saya dengan syarikat saya. Tak ada pekerjaan, saya gunakan semua itulah duit simpanan saya untuk ke sana dengan harapan tak apa, nanti balik ada lagi kerja freelance ni, insya-Allah.
Alhamdulillah,
insya-Allah. Okey, tapi yang nak diceritakan cerita perkumpulan Khadijah Celebrity yang saya jumpa pada Julai 2019 tu dipanggil The Khadijahs. the Khadijahs. Jadi bila saya beritahu tadi, Masya Allah, macam-macam lah individu yang memberi saya inspirasi untuk saya lebih sedar diri dan untuk menjadi versi Hana Ismail yang lebih baik.
Alhamdulillah.
So bila saya ke sana, saya apa ni dah hadir ke satu majlis. Majlis ni merupakan majlis bagi memperingati Sayyidatina Khadijah. Khadijah lagi. Cerita ni kan. Khadijah
macam
lagi.
Macam ada sign-sign macam mana.
Ni Khadijah pergi lagi, Khadijah lagi. Kemudian saya pun pergi ziarah satu makam ni, makam makam Habib Ahmad bin Muhammad Al-Mahdar, tak salah saya, di Dau'an. Inilah Habib sebenarnya yang mengarang kasidah mengenai Sayyidatina Khadijah. Khadijah lagi. Sebab ceritanya Habib Ahmad ni begitu mencintai ninda dia Sayyidatina Khadijah ni. Sampai satu kisah menarik lah masa Habib ni di Mekah, ceritanya lah. Habib ni maksudnya adalah address bagi orang alim yang berketurunan Rasulullah. Itu maksud Habib lah kan. So Khadijah lagi ni, Khadijah kan. So bila saya apa ni balik ke Malaysia, lockdown. Start PKP 1.0. Tak ada kerja, duit simpanan dah habis. Masa tu Masya Allah. Tapi somehow Alhamdulillah, dalam saya PKP tu saya serahlah, serah je dapat Allah kan. Dalam saya terperap dalam rumah tu, ada juga pekerjaan yang datang untuk saya kerjakan secara online. Tu saya buat semua-semua kerja tu melalui online, dapatlah sustain saya sepanjang PKP tu. Kemudian lepas PKP tu dah lifted sedikit, saya dipanggil oleh sahabat saya Ustazah Azni, "Ya, nak boleh tak kita berkumpul sekejap? Saya nak bincanglah pasal penubuhan satu Netflix ni, di mana satu stesen OTT yang baru, macam streaming yang baru, yang kita fokuskan pada sopan. Kesopanan punya konten. Konten-konten yang sopan dan berakhlak kepada, kita bagi alternatif lah dekat orang dekat luar sana kan." Okey. Duduk dengan sahabat saya, berkenalan kawan lagi dengan Diana Amir, orang yang sama yang mengajak saya ke majlis Khadijah ni. "Ana, jom kita buat satu dramedi tak?" "Dramedi apa?" "Kita dramedi pasal kumpulan usrah kita, nama The Khadijahs." Khadijahs lah. Dramedi tu macam drama dan komedi lah. Kan? Drama dan komedi. Khadijah lah lagi kan?
Mau belajar tu.
Itulah cerita yang kata, Khadijah lagi. Dalam pada masa sama, saya juga diajak oleh Habib Hussein, "Jomlah Ana datang, kita kumpulan, ada majlis ibu nak buat ke rumah ni kan Habib ni." Tiba-tiba tu Habib nak tubuhkan House of Sayyidah Khadijah. Khadijah lagi. Dan dalam apa ni grup House of Sayyidah Khadijah ni, saya bersahabat dengan seorang ahli khidmat yang sangat Masya Allah, yang sentiasa mengingatkan saya tentang majlis-majlis dan apa-apa ni. Remind me of God lah. You know, always remind me of God. Guess what's her name? Khadijah juga. So it seems that saya tak boleh lari daripada dengan nama Khadijah ni. Sosok Khadijah ni, Masya Allah.
And even lah. Our crew, member team crew kita, saudara Kamarul, anak dia pun nama Khadijah.
Nama Khadijah. Dan tekalah nama founder Allah. Habib Hussein kita, nama ibu kepada founder Habib siapa?
Khadijah.
Khadijah juga, Masya Allah. Saya tak dapat nak kata apalah. Dan sekarang ni pun saya memang sedang menjaga Zawiyah yang memang untuk Khadijah ni berkumpul. Nama Zawiyah tu adalah Khadijah. Masya Allah, macam itulah cerita dia, sedikit sebanyak lah. Memang saya, Masya Allah.
Dah banyak lah, dah banyak
call. Tapi wallahi, kalau lah saya ada anak perempuan yang pertama, saya nak namakan dia Khadijah. Memang dah lama
pun terdikit. Amin, amin, insya Allah.
Insya Allah.
Okay, so to we, I think it's about time we wrap up this session. Would like to thank you so much for your participation. It's not just kita je, but you as well. Harap korang join kita orang dekat Facebook. Please like our page, Facebook, Instagram of host Khadijah atau House of Sayyidah Khadijah. Speaking of, so Sayyidah Khadijah ni, dia it's a name which kalau you nak carry that name is something to look up for, because Sayyidah Khadijah dia selfless, dia sanggup menggadaikan semua, even dia pernah cakap kan, kalau dia meninggal dulu ke kan, boleh gunakan tulang kita untuk across the rivers or across the lautan untuk sampai ke rumah, sampai macam tu sekali, harta dia semua. So So siapa-siapa yang dekat sana nama Khadijah, alhamdulillah semoga anda juga insya-Allah ada cerminan kepada Sayyidah Khadijah, and semoga House of Sayyidah Khadijah ni cerminan kepada Sayyidah Khadijah dan juga cerminan kepada Rasulullah SAW di dalam membuat kebaikan. Thank you very much to Hana Ismail. Thank you very much for Mada Tahir for your time. Thank you very much to, and thank you very much for all and also Muka. Muka bar. Ha, ada dua muka, muka kat bawah, bar kat atas. Bar untuk bantu. So bantu orang dengan kapasiti sendiri, ataupun kalau nak bantu sama-sama kita bantu, you can join us. Let's make friends or be family. Kita be as one. So okay, and as well ikuti kami di social media, Facebook, Instagram dan YouTube for the latest updates. And shout out juga kepada the event organizers and also our crew Umran TV, especially yang siapa yang bawa bukur ni and kopi, dan terima kasih semua. Sorry, oh yeah. We especially important before we end session, we would like to know the feedback lah. Kita bukan hanya kita nak kita nak tahu sebenarnya, how we can improve ourselves, or if you have a good idea, or kita nak collaborate, or organizations nak collaborate, please reach out to us on our Facebook page, ataupun if you kenal ke Hana, Mahda and me, you can contact me as well. Yeah, so with
and
that,
so as Anna mentioned, we are inshallah we plan, God willing, to have this talk show on a regular basis.
Inshallah.
So if the people can share what do you want to hear? Kadang-kadang kita ni short sendiri kan, we just like self indulgent. Yeah. Oh, they want to hear this.
Let's suggestions.
We give need, a suggestion, your feedback. What do you want to hear? Ideas. What kind of topic interests you? What do you think is good? So you know, and we try to find the right artists, find the right speakers, and try to talk about the things that you want to hear, not the things that we want to talk about, you know. Yes. Not necessarily what we want to talk about is what we want to hear. So share feedback, honest feedback.
So come on, come with the journey together with us lah. The journey sama-sama, insyaAllah. So I will end the session. Semoga we have a next session, interesting session, or probably we have some figura that we could call, and thank you so much. Especially have to thank the pencetus House of Sayyidah Khadijah, which is Sayyid Hussein bin Sheikh Al Junaid, and the team and the crew and everybody as well lah. So terima kasih banyak-banyak kerana menonton rancangan ini. Saya sudahi dengan wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.